All right. Update on the wagon. Let me show you some stuff first. We know that I sold the engine out of the wagon to Cletus. I'm building a new one. I'll show you that later. Like, not later this episode, but later, because it's going to take me a little bit. I have, from all the flack that I took from people online, I have gotten a full containment seat that we're mounting up in here. Full containment seat. Something that will make everybody super happy. You notice that there is also a missing transmission. Well, I got all my transmissions fixed. They're not here yet. But one of the things that I am doing is I'm having a complete carbon fiber molded shell of the transmission to cover it. So it'll just cover all of it, all the hoses, everything, but still have the shape of a, not some lame tube or square, but actual form transmission cover. I got that. And then we know that we have gotten the rear end out of the car. Bert came over and took the rear end out of the car. Now, this rear end is Billy Bad Boy. This is the rear end that was in the car. The problem is we have exceeded the 9.5-inch ring and pinion. Can't get 10-inch gears right now in the gear ratio I need. I need a 370. Can't get them. Gonna be another few months, apparently. And then it's like, you know what? Then you still have the possibility of the same problem. I need to do to the next level. Why does this break? This car weighs 3,650 pounds. This car will, Lord willing, someday go 590s. This car, at that weight, needs to go 1060 foot with the big tire. I have to hit the tire so hard, it breaks U-joints, drive shafts, ring and pinions, all that stuff. So we have had to go up to the next level. So this rear end, which by the way is 22-inch four-link centers, 44-inch flange to flange. Remember that, because this rear end is for sale. I have a different Ultra Case third member 9.5-inch gear. This rear end is for sale if anybody wants it, with brakes, everything, because I have gotten, it just came in, have not unboxed it, have not even looked at it yet. All billet, 12-inch, 2-year guarantee in a Pro Modified car, and this car. So let's unbox this thing, because I have not seen it.
Butterflies too. This is the most exciting thing to ever happen in the history of history.
Man, that is a big mother trucker. Holy cow. Wow.
What the?
Wow, that is... That looks so much larger than what I thought. Wow. Holy cow. All right. Look at that, in all of its glory.
Boy, that thing looks like it came out of some kind of fighter jet or something, and I'll tell you what, rated at 10,000 horsepower at least.
Wow.
Crazy.
Wow, that was...
Dang, I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what.
That thing, whoa,
what
he bad.
Holy mother.
I wonder if it costs so much.
Yes. But it is. This is the next level of what's needed. That is the biggest third center section ever. We need to put that right beside that. We'll take it out of here and see. So that thing is. That is scary big. Holy crap. Wow. Go look underneath the car and show where it's got to fit into. Hey, reminder, tomorrow's video, I'm gonna show you how we take this solid piece of aluminum and turn it into, turn it into this, all billet, SML. Dog's always in the way. All billet, SML. Tomorrow's video, check it out. So then even Dewey's impressed. He's going, what the heck is that? That is, this here is serious. In fact, I am in awe of this thing, because I'm like, wow. It's much bigger than the picture. This is from Mark Williams, obviously. And it's a 12-inch ring and pinion, and that's why they actually guarantee it. And it's a 370 gear set. Has the reluctor wheel on it for the drive shaft sensor. Obviously, 1480 U-joints and drive shaft for this. And then they have a special slip yoke. You know what yoke that is, where we don't have to pull the yoke out of the transmission. It's like this kind of yoke. Right. So some kind of yoke where it's gonna make it easier to get the transmission in and out of the car. But without breaking the transmission, if we don't see the ring, if you break the ring and pinion in these cars and the thing zings up, what it does is it rolls the sprag in second gear. It breaks the transmission. So every time you break a rear end, you have a broken transmission. Period. So we're gonna alleviate that issue, Lord willing here. And I don't know, I'm still stunned at what's all going on here. Because it's a lot. We're gonna pick this thing up and compare it over there size-wise and see what you got. But again, this is what's needed in order to get that big a car, that heavy a car with that much horsepower, to not kill parts. And what's happened, if you paid any attention from sick week, was that when I was going 114, 112, 60 foot, it'll do it all day long. It don't care. But I have to turn it up so much, put so much more power to it. By my math, I'm calculating, I'm putting about almost 400 horsepower more into it on the hit in order to get that car to go into the 10s. And I only went a 110. But every time I did it, I broke a ring and pinion. I broke two U-joints, 1350s. And it's like, we have to go to the next step up. That's this. So, because there's no point breaking parts, and there's definitely no point in going slower. Slowing it down, that would be stupid. What are you gonna slow it down for? So, when we can go faster, we obviously you wanna go faster. And then obviously this screw is somewhat smarter than I am, I think. Or just stuck in there. Well, it's bent. I think I'm gonna, this thing is so pretty. It's just pretty. I mean, it's, you wanna touch it? Can't.
I can't afford to touch it.
Can't afford
to
touch it.
It's out of my price range.
This Pertinier costs as much as your car.
Oh, I believe it. My car doesn't.
It is so big. All right, stud, grab that side of it and we'll pick this thing up.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, that's light too for how big it is.
All right, so there's there. All right, dog, you check it out. Here, let's put it over beside that. The other rear end. We'll see how this thing's going. Ta-da! Dang it. That's You know, interestingly enough, it doesn't look as big. When it was in the box, the thing looked like it was huge. Here, it at least looks like my first thought when I opened the box actually was, old crap. I gotta make sure this thing fits inside my car. And now I'm thinking, okay, I think we're okay. But this is modular rear end, so they build all this stuff. The four link bracketry is all built into it. The wheelie bar, shock mount. Yeah, the wheelie bar and shock mount is all built into it. Oh, this must be upper bar. So what the heck is this? Hey, what do you think? It must be a sway bar? I know what that is. Oh, yeah. So this must be for the sway bar. So probably gonna have to reinvent half the wheel. But hey, why do it once when you can do it twice for three times as much? So the other thing here too is the yoke. So this is a 1480 yoke, so it'll give you an idea. So that's 4.5. And then the 1350 yoke, the common setup is 3 7/8. Yeah, it looks a whole lot beefier, that's for sure. I mean, that's a whole lot of, oh yeah, it's an inch wider here. So it's inch wider from there to there, half inch wider this dimension. So it's definitely big mamba jamba. I don't even know what all the, so they must have an oiler or a pump or something in here. I don't even know what's going on. Oh, look at that. You see this? Check this out. It's got some kind of oil pump right here. What does that say? Pressure lube, yeah. So there's a internal oil pump that must pump, that obviously pumps oil up to the pinion bearing. This must spray and sprays on the ring gear. Ha! That's pretty cool. I'm Steve Morris. Have a great day. Okay, I didn't think Bert was gonna be able to get it done this quick. Bert's a bad dude. He just makes things happen. So anyways, the rear end's already in the car. So let's go under here and check it out. Oh, let's see. And it fits. Yeah. I don't think it's not gonna hit up there. Yeah. We gotta make a little wishbone deal. For my wishbone, that's the center locator, but it has holes down here, so we'll just be able to go down there, yep, and make a mount for that. And then, let's see here. Now these are just my drive shocks. These aren't my good sand huffs. These are just junk. Drive round shocks, and dang, it's already in there. Wow, this is. Dewey, go away. Quit looking the camera.
Well, like save them.
Anyways,
hey, let go.
I'm pretty excited. That's pretty cool. All right, Dewey's gone postal. Dewey, quit it. All right, awesome. Things in here. Let's, I think we're gonna have to set everything up, set the four link up, preload, get it all duplicated with the four link, you know, wizard. So everything's all done the same. And dang, pretty happy about it. This is pretty freaking cool. Now we're done.